Hey folks, happy Saturday, it's Veer Das. I just wanted to talk to you about something incredibly personal to me today. Offensive comedy. I've been seeing a lot of comedians recently doing offensive and abusive jokes, and I do not condone offensive or abusive comedy of any kind. Every time I watch these videos, I'm like, who does this comedian think he or she is to talk about whatever they think they need to talk about within their own freedom of artistic expression? That's ridiculous. Right? Freedom of speech is only truly free if it is limited and controlled in a mutual context that is decided by 1.3 billion people who always agree on every... Sorry, one second, I'm just getting a call. Sorry, my friend is just leaving from work. One second. Hi. Just drive carefully, alright? There's lots of potholes on that highway. There's like accidents every day and there's no medical help at all. It's full of potholes. Also, roll the window up, pollution. The air can kill you. Alright, bye. What I love is India's response to offensive comedy. Every time you find something offensive, you get online and you're like, that joke is offensive. And then you wait for a while. And then somebody else gets online and they're like, I think that joke is offensive too. And you're like, yeah. Yeah. Then you both wait. Because, you know, it's... Sorry, one second. I'm just getting a call. It's my mom. Hi, Ma. You're feeling well? Cool. Have your vitamins because there's no beds for you whatsoever. No, not a single hospital will let you in. No, if you get it, nobody knows. All right, cool. Bye. And then usually like some famous person will join in and be like, I think this joke is offensive too. And then like a huge community of people is like, that's offensive, that's offensive, that's offensive. And then all of you wait for a while. Because, you know, this... Sorry, just one second. Hi. Oh, he's giving a speech? Oh, cool. Is he taking any questions from any of the press? Of course not. No. That never. All right, cool, bye. And then you have taught that comedian a lesson. All right, that you will not tolerate what is offensive in this country. And I applaud... Sorry, give me a second. Yeah. What, somebody called somebody a Madharjot on the news? Which channel? Yeah, that's not really a news channel though, man. They just do whatever they're told to. Okay, cool. I'll talk to you later. We have to stand together to represent our culture, all right? We decide what we find funny. And if we don't find anything funny, then nothing is funny. That is our decision, not the artist. One second, sorry. Oh, this leader said some hardcore. I mean, he has like 45 cases against him. I mean, everything from corruption to... Anyway. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's fine. Let it go. It's nothing you can do. We have taken a decision as far as what we are going to tolerate as a nation. And it's important that we do... Sorry, one second, my friend again. What, your car broke down? No, you can't be on that highway. It's not safe for women anywhere in the country after dark. Call yourself a cab, but make sure... You know what? I can't help you. You're a woman out alone after dark in this country. I don't know what to tell you. It's out of my hands. Who knows where your safety is going to lie? All right, cool. The point is, guys, sorry, I'm keep getting off track. I'll just wrap up the video. When we fix comedy and comedians and fictional jokes with fictional context, then we fix what is really offensive about this country. And that is the one thing, the only thing that is really offensive about our country. And that's the only one that we can do anything about. We fixed it. Once we get rid of these comedians, nothing in India is offensive anymore.